As the market is crashing and panic selling dominates trading, people are realizing that safe havens must be found. With the spread of this new illness, people are not traveling, airplanes do not fly, hotels are rather empty and people are being sent home. Money is not spent, manufacturing is put on hold, businesses suffer, because they have to pay their employees, so more money is lost. Not even the Fed, pumping money into the economy, could stop the downward spiral of the market, in which investors see struggling companies. In times of the market crashing or recession, people will always turn to tangible assets, so if it all goes wrong, they have something tangible to tackle losses. Usually it's about real estate or precious metal. Gold has always been perceived as a haven. But buying gold is not for the faint of heart. Usually investors enter the market rather late, after prices hit historically high levels. The price of gold has been down since it hit its peak of $1,895 an ounce in 2011. The main reason why people buy gold is to preserve their money during a crisis. Gold is the best hedge against a potential stock market crash. It is a well-known fact that gold has been used as a form of currency since 643 BC, so people believe that it will hold its value better than paper currency. Limited supply, however, makes the market both thin and volatile when demand grows. There are few traders who can drive prices up quickly once it looks like there is an upward trend, but at a certain point, gold can quickly become a bubble, and when that bursts, there's a lot to lose. According to experts, the best hedge during turbulent times is not gold. Instead, you should have a diversified portfolio that meets your goals. A safely structured portfolio should have no more than 10% of its assets in gold. It is important to note that when investor confidence is shattered, as it was in 2008, for example, gold prices grew as nervous investors looked for a safe place to put cash pulled out of the market. Gold is a haven in times of inflation because it retains its value much better than currency-backed assets, which may climb in price, but drop in value. Investing in gold with the idea it never loses value is wrong. Like any investment or financial asset, gold is subject to supply and demand, which make the price to fluctuate. In 2008, the price of gold varied from around $720 an ounce to almost $980 an ounce. As the economy sunk further into the recession, gold prices soared to over $1,850 in 2011. It then fell and now, due to fear, it is likely to climb up to new highs. Although the US dollar is one of the world's most important reserve currencies, when the value of it falls against other currencies, as it happened between 1998 and 2008, this often prompts people buy gold, which raises gold prices. The price of gold nearly tripled between 1998 and 2008, reaching the $1,000 an ounce milestone in early 2008 and nearly doubling between 2008 and 2012, hitting around the $1,850 mark. And a little bit of statistic, over the past 30 years, the price of gold has increased by 280%. Over the past 15 years, the price of gold has increased by 278%, basically the same as the 30-year return. In January 1934, with the introduction of the Gold Reserve Act, and August 1971, when President Richard Nixon closed the U.S. gold purchase window, the price of gold was effectively set at $35 per ounce. Since then, a price appreciation of approximately 4,500% can be deduced for gold. In conclusion, as with any investment, it's important to consider the time frame of investing. Gold is not a bulletproof investment, because its price fluctuates. With all investment portfolios, diversification is important, and investing in gold can diversify a portfolio, usually in market declines, when the price of gold tends to increase.